perfect. First thing is, we have the origin of the universe. Second thing, we got fine-tuning of the universe. Third thing is, in the human body, we found DNA, and we looked in DNA, and we all of a sudden realized it's loaded with information.
Yeah, and not
where did that information come from?
Right, and not just the human body, but every cell of every living organism. So if we look at a profound mystery confronting biologists today, which is the origin of the first life, and nearly all scientists, including evolutionary biologists, acknowledge that we have no materialistic evolutionary explanation for the origin of the first cell. How do you get from chemicals in a prebiotic soup to the first cell? And one of the reasons that that's such a problem to explain is that living cells contain, they're not simple, they contain digital information as part of a complex information storage, transmission, and processing system. And in our experience, we know that information always arises from an intelligent source. That's part of our uniform and repeated experience, the basis of all scientific reasoning. So Bill Gates has said, as we've quoted before, that DNA is like a software program, but much more complex than any we've ever created. That remark is highly suggestive, because we know that software comes from programmers, and we know that all forms of information, especially information in a digital or alphabetic form, comes from an intelligent source. So that discovery suggests intelligent design at the beginning of life, and I've argued in my new book that when we take these three discoveries jointly, or take them together, the universe had a beginning, the universe has been finely tuned from the beginning, and since the beginning, we've had big infusions of digital information into our biosphere, that only one of the major worldviews can explain those three great discoveries about biological and cosmological origins, and that's classic theism. All right.